Julia, I'm going to cut this in half, and I'm going to do half in the traditional shape of a scone, and the other half I'm going to do unusual kind of a roll-up because they're fun, interesting.
It's always nice to have other things you can do with a dough.
Yes. This will make, instead of the usual 12 from this, I can do 6. It helps a little to go around the edges so you don't have it flattened.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this should have a little melted butter, which I have right over there on top, and then I'll sprinkle a little sugar on that. Oh. Again, like it gives a nice finish.
Mm-hmm.
And just a tiny bit of sugar. I've got this brush here. Let me just get this kind of all over the top. There.
Well, that's all there is to that.
That's all there is.
That couldn't be more simple, could it? I thought you were going to have to roll it out.
That is the wonderful thing.
Well, that's marvelous.
Home baking. Now we need to put it on a pan.
Does that need to be sprayed or anything?
Not really, because there's a lot of butter in this.
No.
When you have a lot of butter, it'll
take
care of it.
That's amazing. That really is a quick bread.
It certainly is. The marvel about certainly things you bake at home is that you can usually eat them no matter what.
Eat them anyway.
Yeah, eat them anyway. I'm going to put one of these crumbs. I'm going to roll. This is just, as I said, a little different technique.
Mm-hmm.
And make a strip. And then what I'm going to do is sprinkle this with the butter. Once more, we'll do the same technique. Let's see, here's some sugar. I can use this again. It moves it easily. Okay. Now, it's always rolled from the long side.
That's about half an inch thick, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yes. But we'll pull it out a little bit. It can be stretched a little bit.
Oh, the sugar roll.
Yeah, exactly. And sometimes this needs a little pinching along the bottom of the seam, which is exactly what you do with loaves of bread.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to cut off the ends because they look poor. And I'm going to get them down about the same height so they'll bake in about the same time.
Mm-hmm. I suppose you could fill these with things, could you? Could
put all kinds of things in them. Yes, you could use finely chopped nuts. You can use
raisins,
currants. Well, Julia.
Well, that wouldn't be easier. That's it.
It goes in a 425 oven for about 10 to 12 minutes.
Rack in the middle?
Yes. Perfect.
Do we think they're done?
I can smell them. I think they are.
Okay, they must be. Good. Oh, look at those. Oh.
They look right.
Okay.
Oh, perfect.
Are we going to eat them right away?
We're going to eat them right away while they're hot.
Oh, great.
Quickly get them all off.
I don't think I've ever had real scones in England. But I know people who have said
they talk about them forever.
Mm.
Now, Julia, I'm going to fix you a scone the way you will never forget it.
Okay.
First, butter.
Yum.
Then.
You can see it melting into it.
Isn't that wonderful looking?
On top.
And then I'm going to put them on this side.
Mm.
Put the top right on. This may look like a little excess, but you're going to like it a lot.
That's what it's supposed to be, I guess.
Yes.
Oh, holy. That's lovely.
Julia.
Well, thank you. I don't think I'll share this with anybody. Oh, it's lovely, lovely and flaky.
All those little lumps of butter worked.
Hmm. Mm, I can see why they talk so much about it. Oh, my. That's lovely.
Well, I'm so glad you like them. We've got lots more, Julia.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Marion is now going to show us Irish soda bread. It's a quick bread, and I don't really know what it is. So what is it?
It's a very simple four ingredients. 4 cups of flour. I'm going to put in about a teaspoon and a half of salt.
And this is regular all-purpose flour.
This is all-purpose flour unbleached.
Unbleached, all-purpose, right. Nope.
And then we're going to have a teaspoon of soda, hence the name.
Actual soda. Yeah.
Then, what's going to raise this bread is the addition of this 2 cups of buttermilk, which when it meets the baking soda, it fizzes, and it's bubbles that make it happen. So,
when you use soda, do you have to bake the bread right away?
Yes, you do. You have to have your oven set to go, and because you don't want to dissipate that bubbly action. I buttered the bottom of that.
You just buttered the bottom of it, not the sides.
No, because it's going to be a little mound there. It's not going to touch the sides.
I see.
I'm going to sprinkle the board with a little bit of flour and turn this out. This is about as elementary as you can get, isn't it? And again, this is really just to bring the dough together.
This really is a quick bread.
It's quick as quick can be. This too feels...
Well, that's a soft dough, isn't
mm-hmm.
it?
No. It is.
I can smell the buttermilk.
I know.
It's rather nice, isn't it?
Again, it has that very wholesome kind of smell here. Can you believe that we're done?
No.
I know.
That's amazing.
And I'm going to do that cross, which is very traditional, and it also keeps it from cracking in odd places.
Is that ready to bake already?
It's all ready to go.
That certainly was fast. What's your oven? 375.
375 for about 50 to 60 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
This bread has baked 50 minutes. It was cooled. Wrapped and left overnight, and it's golden. And
well, that looks like bread, doesn't it? I mean, it looks perfectly fine. You just eat it just like regular bread.
Eat it just like regular bread.
Butter and jam.
The Irish ate this every single day.
Toast very nicely.
I would think very nicely.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you. That was fun. It's so easy and quick.
Yeah, just a couple of minutes and you have it made.
Better than the bread machine. Thank you, Mary. Now one of the greatest quickies of them all, and certainly the most dramatic, popovers, which Mary now is going to make in a thrice, or a whisk, or what?
First, 1½ cups of flour.
Love popovers.
They're quite wonderful. They're sort of exciting, even though you've had them many times. They can be 1½ cups of milk, same amount as the flour.
Is this just regular 2% milk?
Just right. And we're going to have a little bit of salt, a teaspoon. And 3 eggs.
Those are U.S. grated large eggs?
Yes, they are large eggs.
Always using large eggs.
Always using large eggs.
That makes good sense.
And here we have 3 tablespoons of melted butter. This is embarrassingly simple, Julie. We stir down the sides so the flour's all in there. Now,
you've got a great big pan.
Well, they should be separate, the containers. This is the secret to making a popover that pops and really gets tall, is that the cups aren't touching each other so that the heat encircles them. That's why if you have to use a muffin pan, fill only the outer muffin.
Uh-huh. These are about two-thirds full.
Right.
That's right. Exactly 9 cups.
That's it.
Now.
Right into the oven.
What kind of an oven do they go into now?
425.
425 oven.
And they take about 20 to 30 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
But you should peek in. I mean,
keep looking at it. Gosh, I thought it was beautiful, Mary.
They're just
heavenly.
Perfect.
They look just perfect.
Shall I just put them right up here and break it apart?
Boy, look at all that steam coming out in there. My, dig in.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have mine with honey because I like...
I think I'll do that too.
I like to run it down the elbows. Marion, think of all that we've done in this less than half an hour. We've done those beautiful muffins, and we've done scones, and those twistums, and soda bread, and now popovers. That's amazing. That's really, anyone can do them. They're
anyone.
So quick and so delicious.
And they're so inexpensive.
And I thank you so much for being with us.
I've loved you.
It's been wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you.
Complete recipes for all the breads, cakes, cookies, and pies in this series and more are available in the Baking with Julia cookbook. Over 500 pages, detailed instruction, and 100 color photos. To order